Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm looking up, just as an example, since we're in Orlando, the Orlando Police Department.
Right.
And I'm grabbing a publicly known number. So I see this number here. I'm putting it into my spoofing software. I'm saving it. And now I'm calling you. As simple as that is, that took all of 60 seconds. And what will happen is the number that comes up on your phone will be the literal Orlando Police Department's phone number.
Okay.
If you were to hang up and call that number back, you would get the Orlando Police Department.
Well, let's do that.
Okay, so.
Let me do that real quick. So what I'm doing is I'm calling back the number you just gave me, spoofing the Orlando Police Department, see if it really is the Orlando Police Department.
You have reached the Orlando Police Information Desk. If this is an emergency, please hang up and dial 911.
So that's it.
And this is an attack that happens. So people will say, how do I know if you're from there? The attacker says, okay, look, hang up, call that number back. You'll hit a main switchboard. You can't get directed to me because I have an internal extension. I'll call you back in 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Person hangs up, they call, they get the message you just heard.
Right.
Now the attacker calls back and it just seems legitimate.
Can you look up the Internal Revenue Service and try that?
Yes, I can. Just seeing if that one comes up.
What is this number now?
The White House.
This is the White House.
I'm calling you from the White House.
Okay. Let's see if we call that number back, what happens? Okay, so now I'm dialing the number you just called.
Thank you for calling the White House comment line.
And here's the part of the attack that helps build the trust is because I can call you to make it look like from any number. And then if you were to call that number back, you get the real office.
Yeah.
And if I call you back again from that number, you now go, okay, yeah, this must be RIP because I just called it and it is the IRS.